This is Vivek Verma along with Safahad Hussain and Saurabh Kumar, and today we are going to present the topic pumping lemma. So Saurabh, please slide the next page. So what is pumping lemma? Pumping lemma is used to prove that a language is not regular. It cannot be used to prove that a language is regular. There are two types of pumping lemma: context-free language, regular language. For a regular language, pumping lemma is used to prove that a language is not regular. It cannot be used to prove that a language is regular. In simple term, this means that if a string V is pumped, that is, if V is inserted and any number of times, the resultant string still remain in L. Saurabh, please. Next slide. So, and pumping lemma is used as a proof for irregularity of a language. Thus, if a language is regular, it always satisfies pumping lemma. If there exists at least one string made of pumping lemma, which is not in L, then L is surely not regular. The positive of this may not always be true. This is, if pumping lemma holds, it does not mean that the language is regular. So I am requesting to Saurabh to please continue the presentations.
So hello sir, I am Saurabh Kumar. The second type of pumping lemma is called context-free language. Pumping lemma is used to prove that a language is not context-free. Pumping lemma for CFL states that for any context-free language, L, it is possible to find two substrings that can be pumped any number of times and still be in the same language. For any language L, we break its string into 5 parts and pump second and fourth substring. Pumping lemma here also is used as a tool to prove that a language is not CFL. Because if any one string does not satisfy its conditions, then the language is not CFL. So there is an example that came in the gate exam. The question is, prove that L01 equals to 0 to the power n, 1 to the power n, and n is greater than 0, is not regular. So let us assume that L is regular. Then by pumping lemma, above given rules follow.
Just interrupt, coach. Ek tu first theke start korbe. Amar microphone, amar mistake. Microphone to on chilo, noise chache prochur. Ek tu first theke start korna, please. Kichu hobe na. First theke একদম স্যার,
ওকে স্যার, ওকে, নো প্রবলেম স্যার, নো প্রবলেম,
ঠিক আছে ঠিক আছে, ওকে.
গুড ইভিনিং স্যার, দিস ইজ বিবেক বর্মা অ্যালং উইথ সাফাদ হুসেন এন্ড সৌরভ কুমার.
বিবেক ভাই, লেট মি স্টার্ট.
ওকে 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 ওকে.
গুড ইভিনিং স্যার, দিস ইজ সাফাদ হুসেন and we are here to present on the topic pumping lemma along with my friends Saurabh Kumar and Vivek Verma. Can I have the first slide? So introducing pumping lemma, as you can see, pumping lemma is used to prove that a language is not regular. Okay, so it cannot be used to prove that a language is regular. There are basically two types of pumping lemma. One is context-free language and the other one is regular language. Talking about regular language, when we are talking about regular language, here pumping lemma is used to prove that a language is not regular. It cannot be used to prove that a language is regular. In simple terms, we can say this means that if string V is pumped, that is, if V is inserted any number of times, the resultant string still remains in L. Next slide. Pumping lemma is used as a proof for irregularity of a language. Thus, if a language is regular, it always satisfies pumping lemma. If there exists at least one string made from pumping lemma is not in L, then L is surely not regular. The opposite of this may not always be true. That is, if pumping lemma holds, it does not mean that the language is regular. I would request Saurabh Kumar to continue or Vivek.
Yeah,
Vivek, please continue.
Okay. Hello sir, I'm Vivek Verma. I'm going to explain the context-free language. Pumping lemma is used to prove that a language is not context-free. Pumping lemma for CFL states that for any context-free language, L, it is possible to find two substrings that can be pumped any number of times and still it be in the same language. For any language L, we break its string into five parts and pump second and fourth substring. Pumping lemma here also is used as a tool to prove that a language is not CFL, because if any one string does not satisfy its condition, the language is not CFL. Next slide, please. Let's we take an example. Proof L01 is equal to O ka power n, 1 ka power n, where n is greater than 0 is not regular. Let assume that L is a regular, then by pumping lemma, the above given rules follow. Now let X belongs to L and X greater than equal to N. So by pumping lemma, there exists U, V, W such that 1 minus 3 holds. We suit that for all U, V, W, 1 minus 3 does not hold. If 1 and 2 hold, then X is equal to 0 power N, 1 power N is equal to U, V, W with U, V less than N and V greater than equal to 1. So U is called there is a Saurabh, please. For sorry, little bit hazy. It's not clear, sir. The word is very hazy. Pumping length for a backslide. Pumping length for a regular language. Next slide. This thing. Pumping length for a regular language. Back, Saurabh. Previous one, Saurabh. Hello. Pumping length for a regular language makes sure that any string in that language with the length greater than pumping length has some repetitions. If we take about DFA, then it repeats some states. If we talk about regular grammar, then it repeats at least one non-terminal in derivation. So now I'm requesting Saurabh to continue with the presentations.
Let us suppose. Hello, sir. I'm Saurabh Kumar. Let us suppose PP is pumping length, then any string WW that has length greater than PP must be repetition. So S directing to AX, which is directing to AWX and WS till W. If it repeats XX two times, and if you notice, we can generate infinitely many strings by choosing numbers of repetitions to be 1, 2, 3 or any value. Does this make any regular language an infinite language? No, we already know that regular language are finite too. What goes wrong here is nothing. For finite language, pumping length is greater than the longest string. And the definition of pumping length is that any string that is greater than P, and there are no strings which is greater than PP, which makes definition trivially true. Now coming to the easiest part, which is solving the equation with clear definition in mind. First, construct DFA. Option A says that any string that has length 33 or greater than to have some repetition. Obviously false. B10 is a string in language and doesn't repeat any state. Moreover, any string with length greater than 10 needs to repeat states. Therefore, 24 will be the answer of the first question. That's it.
Okay, thank you very much.